O Paulo não está.
Okay, can you speak in English? So.
Okay.
You can speak in English. I think this part. Leonor? Okay. In this moment, I think it's good for us to have a kind of partilha,
share
of experiences in our areas, in our work, in our experience, even in municipality, even in at school, even at the artist work of everybody, and this kind of this kind of share is important to know what we do, in our lives, in our artistic lives, in our jobs, what we do, and how this meeting can help us in our activities. Okay, if somebody wants to start, and then we make everybody can speak a little bit about his activity, and we try to cross opinions about the job, about if somebody needs to know something about the job of the other. And I think it's the moment of like not therapy. Help to understand what we do actually.
Então o Leftim está a querer
We need to translate.
Incentivar a partilha, que se calhar agora é um momento para as pessoas se darem um bocadinho a conhecer o que é que fazem, em que medida é que estes encontros podem ajudá-los nas suas atividades, e a partir de quem iniciar pode-se cruzar com outro comentário, com perguntas de alguém sobre o seu trabalho.
In case of you, if you don't speak English, don't worry, because Claire or Leonor can translate.
We'll translate.
Okay? Because I think it's important for everybody to understand what. Who wants to start? So it's good for us to know what.
About me.
Okay. Yeah, if you want.
So I started my training for this kind of work in London. I was participating in an organization called Community Music, and that was about learning how to do music in the community with all different kinds of groups, like children, old people, people with learning difficulties or handicaps. So generally a training. And the training was very similar to what we did here. Everyone brought ideas and they shared their ideas, and we created games and activities. And then coming to Portugal, I gradually started working in this area. I've done many different my interest is more creative music, being creative with music and sound, not worrying that nobody, on the fundamental principles is nobody has to have any knowledge or ability before doing it. Anyone can make music, and bringing out people's creativity and developing their confidence in being able to express themselves with music, and music, can touch and sound. So that's how I started. And in my time in Portugal, I've worked for many different organizations. I've done workshops in different parts of the country, different age groups, mainly children and young people. And I've done a lot of work in what they call in Portuguese, bairros sociais. So a lot with children and young people who are in these kind of socially deprived areas, and most of the population are either third or fourth generation ex-African colonies of Portugal, or they're from the there's quite a large gypsy population in Portugal, I mean in the area where we usually work. And then there are of course some from Brazil, and Portuguese, and some Eastern European countries. So I finally started working with Moos 10 years ago. And most of my work has been in the primary school, so working with children from 4 years old, four or five, up to 11. And so the work I do is mainly based on all the different elements of music production, which is singing, creating sound, rhythm, exploring objects and creating sound and objects using your imagination. I mean, I try to experiment a lot, and we try to work with the teachers a lot. So I'm all trying to keep a dialogue with the teachers. What are you doing in your lesson? Can I do something in music that complements that? So for example, with the younger children, they almost always do something about autumn. So we do some autumn soundscape or something, you know, and it can change every year. Sometimes I create a project. So 1 year we had during the Chinese New Year, in February, the teachers created these big dragons that the children wore. So half the group was playing instruments like music, and the other half was dancing. The dragon was dancing. So that's an example of when you can collaborate. It's really great. You know, it really is inspiring. It's not easy always. Depends a lot on the teachers. We have some teachers who are very engaged and want to work with us. Sometimes we have teachers who, they're not interested, or they have no sensitivity. So, you know, one of my big difficulties is the question of behavior, because some of the teachers, if the child is not behaving, they shout at them, or they want to get a little bit kind of physical, and I always say, no, let the child, if they want to do it, it's okay. If they don't, it's not a problem. I don't want to force. So we have kind of situations like that sometimes. This last year, I was working as well with children from the secondary school, so it's like 12, 13 years old, and I had one of the best years ever because the teacher I was working with was really, really engaged. I never have had an experience, and this for me is proof that that makes incredible difference. So she decided at the beginning of the year to do a project on diversity. That was the title, diversity. And then in my sessions of Moos with them, I was able to do sound, video, dance. I did a whole mixture of different, like multimedia, multi-performance. And during the year, the children were also incredible class. They were all really interested, really engaged. Some of them more timid, but everyone you saw during the year, how everyone was able to, even the most shyest little girl who I knew her. That's another nice thing about our work, is because we work in the same, in the school we've been working in for 10 years. So we create a relationship with the children. So some of the children in this class, in the secondary school, they knew me from, they were with me from when they were very little. So, and this one girl, she was always so shy, and during this year, she really, you could see her coming out. So for me, that's like, for me, the essence of what we're trying to do in the end is enable a child to really feel their own confidence and express themselves. Is that enough? Yeah. I could talk for hours, but there's so much to say. But yeah. And for me, these sessions are really precious because we all work alone. We don't share, even if, you know, me and Leonore are in the same school, but we never meet. Mm-hmm. You know, so there's, it, you know, from every session yesterday, I got ideas. So, you know, thank you to everybody who created, who shared their work. And for me, it's fantastic, and I can use everything. And it's important to get new ideas, because,
I started working at the museum about 4 years ago. I started it in Győr. Győr is a town halfway between Wien and Budapest on the border. I started the work with a very, very hard group. The children, that was about just 10 children in the class, but it was a full gypsy class in a, in a segregation in here. And we were three muse teachers for 10 children.
Yeah.
It was very hard to need three muse teachers. And we moved to Budapest, and now working, last day I worked in different school. One of them was a simple Hungarian school, and the other is a multicultural school in the city center in Budapest.
Sorry, what, when you say multicultural, what kind of country?
Nations, yes. I had 17 children and 17 children and just 2 Hungarian.
Okay.
50
yeah.
Children, for example, Palestinian, Vietnamian, one or two gypsy children, I don't know, so just 2 Hungarian children. And this situation isn't was the problem. The problem was that 50 children was has very, very big familial problem in 17. That was the problem, not the cultural differences, the problematic family. And
also the teachers in that school was acting like they were just concentrating to have the all the children in silence and
they don't have any garden. They don't have
any free space, any
no.
Space to go out.
And,
in,
during the break, these children don't didn't able to go out from the
classroom.
The lead teacher of the class was very, 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 very
strict.
Yes, it's a very, very big problem in Hungary. I worked many youth teachers who behave
like that.
But I try to communicate and try to work together. I always try to help with the team, the main team.
The lecture.
The lecture. Main lecture. I try to use lectures in a user way, making easier and happier this process in the schools. My specialty is puppet and drama and theater. I love using puppet because not just in the children, in adult people also. The puppet isn't a children technique, it's a tool. Because when somebody very shy, you can hold between the
distance, yeah,
between
you and the puppet.
And puppet
just a play, it has no purpose, it's no meaning, it's not important, just something they spend an hour with and they are going anywhere. And it's a very, I've been teaching drama for 10 years, doing theater in education in Hungary for more than 10 years, and it's developing really slow, the acceptance. Some teachers see theater in education, drama, puppet play or something, anything.
Stolen time.
They think it's a stolen time from teaching maths and teaching important things. And it's changing really, really slow. There are a few good teachers, there are a few teachers that are really involved and see the value of the whole thing, but the majority of the teachers are looking
at
playing. Yes. And also, I think also the artistic teachers' value is the same in the AR. So they don't see us as real teachers. They see us as like a free activity for the children.
And I understand his or her point, because I graduated as a simple elementary or primary school teacher. I'm a simple teacher, so I know why is it very hard for the simple teacher in elementary school. Yes, so I see it and I understand it. That's why, in my opinion, I'm good at creating a bridge between this two camps. I don't know. This is my mission.
Sorry, I have to
maybe it has to crash this wall between artistic teachers and normal teachers, I don't know how to say, basic teachers and the parents, yeah. So I think in this way they will be, that there's more opportunity to show them that this work has a lot of value with the children.
Okay, thank you.
So in my case, maybe what I can share with you is my experience in the Homelands project that had place the last year, because in Belgium I just have like 2 years and a half living there, and so being in this project has a great experience personally, because it helped to me a lot in my integration, and so I was working maybe due to the COVID, the project has to be stopped. We have to stop for some weeks, so that's why the project takes more time. But I was, I think, very lucky, because we had a group of, like, we were working with adults, but they were very involved with the project. So first we had a training week and all these activities to prepare the workshop. Then when we start, I was I had like a partner, a musician, that it was a big support to me, because he helped a lot with the translation, and because we did the workshops in French. So at the beginning it was a bit not a barrier, but yeah, it was a little bit difficult for me to try to express what I have in my head, try to express, because there was a limit of language. But then, with the time we were passing, so I was feeling more comfortable. And when I saw that the group were very involved and they wanted to do something, so I felt you know, more, I had more impulse, I feel more. And so we were working in with adults from a music school. And we were a group like at the beginning, like 10 or 12. But when the COVID get the worst period, there were some participants that say, okay, I will stop because I don't want to, you know, to be in the group. And so, okay, but we, the people were free to choose if they want to continue or not. But we were lucky because just, I think just two persons say, hey, I will stop. But then the group continue working, and when we couldn't continue with the face-to-face meetings, so we proposed to, okay, let's do it at distance, so by Zoom, or we're going to share the information by email. And so the good thing is that even the COVID, we found a way to continue with the project. And so about the project, so as we were in a music school, so the music, I think, it was a very important element. And also, we had many workshops with the group. The first workshop we start to do, let's say, brainstorm.
Yeah.
So, starting to discuss. So, first, present ourselves and know between each other and things like this. Then we start to discuss the, for example, what I said yesterday, the poem, what means for you. So we start to express, and we take like four workshops doing this, and then sharing ideas, what can we do? Can we do something of theater? Or maybe it's better to create music because we are in a music school, or what can we do? And then my partner and me, we had the idea to do like a little documentary. So, and we proposed it to the group, and they said yes, we can do it, because it was very, I think at the end it was a nice choice, because a documentary, but from the beginning we say, okay, but we want something that everybody feels identified with the final result. It doesn't matter if it is, you know, like a professional and the, you're filming of very high quality, no, it doesn't matter. Because everyone now has a telephone, so we say, okay, just take your telephone and just you can start filming, for example, film in your home, your favorite place where you feel comfortable. And so everyone week per week they start to share the material. So I have this in my home, for me, I feel comfortable in the living room, for another person in the garden. And so we start to have a lot of material. start to feel things that because of their the participants were living in that region,
yeah.
So they were in their place, and so at the end we start to when we have enough material, we start to do the edition of the video, and then at the same time we had a lot of workshops that were very interesting, and we created the music also. So all the documentary was made by ourselves, even the music. We record the sounds, the voices, we wrote some phrases, and we recorded, we were recording all the phrases, and then we used all this material, and we had at the end a documentary around the last around 15 minutes. So what I can at the end, but I can keep from all this experience is that we were working with adults. Some of them around 60 years, and but they're
60.
60, yes, 60 years. Mm-hmm. But there was always a you know energy. They wanted to do something, and to at the end it was very incredible when we have finally the complete video, and it was very nice to in the video each participant at the end they can say, oh, that is what I filmed, that's my house, oh, that is the park near from where I live, oh, that's my voice saying, and it's a very interesting to the co-creation. And what personally, when I started this project, I didn't know about co-creation. And but it's a very good way to work, because at the end it's the idea that everyone feels identified with the final result. And yeah, the group was very happy. They were very satisfied with our video. And so, due to the COVID, we don't have the chance to do a presentation of that video, but. We're still waiting for a chance, for a place to do that, and the group is still motivated to that we maybe later we can do a presentation. And so yeah, that's my experience with the project, and then I. So I'm very happy also to be working with the foundation, because these days I had another opportunity to share with you, and always we learn a lot of things, and what else?
Thank you.
I think that I can say.
Thank you very much.
That's part of the foundation. But it's interesting to meet the people that really are working locally, and that I, so it's more concrete, like what I'm doing behind my desk and organizing this, like, okay, I know why I'm doing it. So thank you all for sharing your experience with me. And about the Homelands project, it's really great for me actually to get to learn more about Leandro and how the experience and the project helped him to be more comfortable in Belgium, I will.
Yeah.
And for us it's really a great exchange also, because we learned so much from him and from the other artists that participate in the project. But yeah, this is a really great tool to
but it's nice to have other ideas and other inputs that can help us innovate with the workshops that we did. And hope that it was helpful for you all, but and for Olivia today.
Thank you.
I can just kind of add, I really resonate with the things you said about the teachers and the situation of working in disadvantaged neighborhoods, and of course also the COVID extra.
That is important for me because for me MUS is like the one time in my life that I share with other arts, other people from different arts than mine. Mm-hmm. Then before MUS I was always with people dancing, mm-hmm. always with dance teachers. Yes, it's classical and contemporary and creative dance, but I don't know how to do other dances as well, like hip hop or danças tradicionais. I don't know that, I'm just this. So, for me this is very good, because I thought that I couldn't do creative writing or drawing. I thought that I was like, oh my god, no. But then, I realized that, okay, this is nice, I can do this. And so the children can think this too, and then change, like me. Maybe for dance as well. I'm finishing my PhD in dance teaching, and it's about emotions. Emotions in creative dance. For me, we don't have much difficulties in MUS Leiria. I think we are very lucky. All the teachers are nice and they say to the kids, you see, this is like math. This is so important, mm-hmm. as math and as other things. And they like the children to do everything, like when they are not doing, because they are bad behaviouring. The teachers go, you see what she's saying? You have to do that. So I think the teachers that I have.
The one you were trying to imitate was Rosa, yes?
Yes,
you see?
Of course.
Yeah, yes.
Children. I didn't have much contact with children And it was a great discovery. And then, after 2011, I worked in the same school that Claire and Eftinius with little children. Since the first grade to the fourth, and then 2 years ago with children after 10, 11, 12. And I was hearing all of you, and the experiences are a bit similar and a bit distant, but there are, beginning with the teachers, there are teachers who are much engaged and attentive, they hear the students, they see them, they want to know new facets, new
aspects
of their lives, and there are teachers that are tired and not motivated, and yes, and they are not so sensitive. I had a great year, the past year, well, not a great year in the sense of the confinements and all the challenges, internal, external, but even those confinements showed me a great thing, that small is beautiful. Sometimes me, not the teachers, me, I was expecting or working to a goal or to, in creative writing, to write more. And then with confinement, it struck me that no, just being able to write, to express things in short sentences, it's going to be released, a book. The most important thing is that it's not a storybook. It has many, many stories inside, but it's all not a collection, not like this. It's all as testimony, like a group diary. I only said the beginning of the sentences, and they ended. There are days when only this. There are days when, but there are days when, and all the ups and downs of their lives are in that testimony. And it was the job that filled me more, not the job that gave me more work in the sessions. We worked other aspects, but it was very, who said that working with emotions, you studied emotions, you were saying, Catherine, something about, when I say less is more, or the, that resonates with something that you inspire me to say. Because sometimes we go along with the teacher's pressures, we can go along with the numbers needs or something, and in the first confinement I have to work with Claire online with a class. It was very defined. It was very exciting because it was new to co-create, even with the screen on front. was new, and that helped me learning that small, the process. Once more, the process is the important thing. And something, it's like sometimes writing, I believe that talking is writing. And there is a space to share. You can share it with dance, with drawing, with writing, not sanctifying writing as a noble art only for those who cannot make mistakes and have to be original. Starting with the emotions, with the share. And that's it.
Thank you.
But you can, if you want, you can say with me something about our experience. I'm a coordinator of MUSE in Fermo from 10 years. I think that MUSE is the only situation in Italy that can promote an exchange among the artists, and it is very important because also to stay here in these days, it was important because we have seen exchanged our experience, and I think that to see how you work. You working in with the adults or with the children is important. So every situation that promotes this exchange, I think is good. And MUSE in this is very important because for us is the only opportunity. Not only for Fermo, but in general in Italy, there are no situation like MUSE. We make a national training with the artists of MUSE in Italy every year, but to have the possibility to exchange with the international artists is very, very important. So, thank you for giving us this opportunity. About the experience, particularly, it was very interesting for me to hear your proposal because I come from that field, that is the literary field, the creative writings. My job is to write, and I am the owner of a little publishing house. So in every situation that I can do something you have shown yesterday is very interesting. For example, your exercise suggests me an experience linked to Gianni Rodari. I don't know if you,
yes,
okay.
I love him.
Gianni Rodari is a great because it was a teacher, he worked with the children, and is a very creative.
With words. He worked with words.
Yes, he's a great creative. When you come in Italy, I hope you come in Fermo for this project. Probably we can play to to make an experiment also with the creative writing using the Rodari methods. So. What can I say? It's important for me to have with me Francesco because Francesco is the representative of the municipality of Fermo. It was also vice mayor of Fermo, so it's a young man. He's an actor because he has worked in theater for a lot of years, and has the sensibility to understand what yesterday and today we have made here. I'm happy that you are here. So if you want to say something,
when I was vice mayor of Fermo, we signed an agreement between the municipality of Fermo and Muse Fermo to put the activities of Muse in our schools, our library, many events during the year. And Muse became the charity partner, for example, for theater, for the Christmas activities in the city. And yes, and in particular in a neighborhood of the city that has problems for many types of people come from all over the world.
Okay.
And so we have a public school that is the most important point to create cooperation and activities and sports and games for all children there. And we care about this school because this, you know, it's a point to create good feelings, to build, to mettere a fianco, come si dice,
to put together.
Yeah, together, yes, Italian and Syrian and Israelian and all.
We have the 80% of children in the school of Lido Triarchi that is of not Italian origin.
80.
Is a lot of our children.
A lot.
Okay.
Yes.
So it's important Muse because it's an informal training that can give the possibility to the children to be creative without using language, with body, with music, with drawing. So this is the difference. I hear your what you said before in Hungary and the difficult to find the sensibility to the teachers. It's not the situation in Italy for us because we have a lot of teachers that ask us to do Muse in the classroom, a lot of situation. We have an organization that is private organization. Our money is private money. So it's very difficult to find, so it's important the charity, to be the charity relationship with the municipality, because in the theater, in the Christmas, the people give us money for having a organization that now involved about 350 children. That is a lot of is an important number in a town that counts
40,000
inhabitants.
Small, so for Italy.
We are small, but we are important in Italy because our partners are Rome, Torino, Genova, Florence, Bologna,
yes,
and Fermo. Do you know Fermo? I think no. Fermo is a very beautiful town near the sea and near the mountains. So I hope you'll find a possibility to come with the project, but also if you want to come.
And we are UNESCO Learning City.
Right. Okay.
So we are in the net, international net of learning city in the world, and this is a reason
to visit.
Not only, but
because Francesco is
because
also
Muse is linked with the city, no?
Okay.
Because this is, I know that in Portugal there are two learning cities. I don't know how, but there are two learning cities. One are in 160 in the world, and
okay,
two are in Portugal.
And this is important this because the learning city of Fermo involved also the popular university, that is an organization for the training of adults, that is the object of this project. So this is the reason for which I, but also Francesco, is here, and I hope we will come another meeting, I hope.
So I expect you in Italy.
Yes,
okay.